for the first place trophy at this point.
And the title.
and the title. So here's how this is going to work. Just so you know, we planned that if there was a playoff, we were going to do it on this side of the course.
Okay.
So that side is gone. You'll start on hole 12. You'll just go through the course, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, until a winner's decided. If you get to hole 24 and there's not a winner that's decided, we'll come right back here to hole 12.
There will be.
Okay? So good luck, and thank you guys. This is exciting.
Oh,
and Paige, you'll have the box with the hot round during the third round.
Paige Pierce first to tee. Gets
open. You're in the open.
Tree low.
Well, kick out into the open. Sarah Holcomb going with a nice turnover, and that's fading nicely. Shove a long putt for possibly a birdie. Long running jump putt by Pierce. She's next to the pin. Oh, and just off of the basket. And Holcomb and Paige have tapped out. They're going to move on to the second playoff hole, hole number 13. During her 150 class, PA1, Paige Pierce has just put the pressure on Holcomb. And Holcomb throwing a turnover forehand. Little kick. She's going to have a putt. And Holcomb makes good from 22 feet. And Paige is in from 10. We're going to our third playoff hole, hole number 14.
Get up.
And Paige throwing low on the hillside on the right. And Holcomb throws a great shot up toward the pin. She'll have a putt. This may or may not be our final hole. And Paige is in for the three. She wanted to be aggressive on that second shot. Caught the tree, however, still keeps the pressure on. Sarah can make this for the win. And Sarah Holcomb is your champion here at the Rocky Mountain Women's Disc Golf Championships.
I'm the Disc Golf Guy, and this is my video blog. I'm out here at Purple Park, outside of Denver or Boulder, beautiful Colorado. That's all that really matters. I am joined by our Rocky Mountain Women's Disc Golf Champion, Sarah Holcomb. Sarah, extra holes, as if 72 holes weren't enough. Tell everyone what happened.
Well, it wasn't on my list to play more than 24 today. But, you know, it turns out I bogeyed the last hole, threw it in the water. And we were tied. Me and Paige Pierce went into a playoff. It was, you know, she's just such a competitor. You know, she offered to split, and I was like, yep.
Wow, what a sweetheart, huh?
That's she
a sweetheart
is, deal. You know, but, and then, you know, we came out, we played on the back. We started at 12. You know, it's a bunch of sidearm holes all the way through there. And on the fourth hole?
Third hole.
Made a putt.
Yes,
for the
you
win.
Did.
Yeah.
Yes, you did. It was a very good battle. You had Paige by 5 strokes, I think, going into this morning, and she came out firing right away.
Oh, yeah.
You had a few tough breaks, and she was just doing what she does, and she was putting the pressure on. What were you thinking as you had even just 2 or 3 holes to go? Was there anything that was going through your mind, or just the same game plan?
Definitely the same game plan. I try to block out anything extraneous going through my mind, especially towards the end of rounds. Because that's usually bad news.
Okay. Well, that's nice. Now, you talked before the round that hole 13 is your favorite hole. You almost finished it on hole 13, but it went on to hole 14 for the finals. What's special about hole 13?
Oh, really? It's my lucky number, first of all.
Okay.
I love the 3 and then the negative, the 13, I kind of like that.
You flip
it. Yeah, it flips for me. And then I aced the hole in practice, so, you know, the first ace I've had in a couple of years.
Okay.
So that was pretty special.
Wow. Well, anything you'd like to say about this amazing weekend? I've been here, we've been sweating it out and having a great time, but any parting shots you'd like to say to everyone out there?
Man, there were 130 women out here. Doug and Ray are killing it when it comes to women's tournaments and, you know, stepping the bar up. And, you know, if anybody needs help on running a women's event, these two guys know how to do it. And all these ladies committed to coming. There were like 50 women on the wait list. Definitely put this tournament on your list in 2 years from now. 2017 Rocky Mountain Women's Disc Golf Championship is where you should be.
Absolutely. Well, by the time everyone has watched this, they're probably already seeing some Vibram or Maple Hill action, where I know you've been crowned champion there. So we're going to let you get on the road so you can go get practice up. It's on the other side of the country.
It's only 28 hours.
Just 28 hours. Just a little jaunt.
Stop, skip, and a skip.
Something
jump,
like
pop,
that.
Jump and a skip.
A jump, putt, and a skip.
Or
a jump, putt, and a deuce. I don't know. All right, well, again, for the Rocky Mountain Women's Disc Golf Championships and all the amazing staff and people out here, this is your champion, Sarah Holcomb. We'll catch you guys next time when you throw in lower altitudes. All right, I have managed to catch up with the masterminds behind the Rocky Mountain Disc Golf Championships. Wow. Ray Woodruff, along with Doug Bjarkus. I almost called you Paige because I'm so used to saying your amazing daughter's name who played so well. Guys, we're here. We're at the end of it. You can exhale a little bit until you get everything packed up. Ray, start. Tell everybody what this weekend means to you.
Frankly, it's a time for women out there to enjoy the sport and for us to embrace it and bring more women in. And that's really what I enjoy most about it.
And now you had 2 competitors close to your heart playing more? Or?
My dear wife, who I've married almost 20 years now, and my 16-year-old daughter both played the event and loved this course. So.
And were very helpful as well, correct?
We put them both to work.
There you go, whether they wanted to or not. Happy Father's Day, of course.
Thank you very much.
All right, too. And Doug, you also had competitors, so you had a vested interest, a superstar daughter, a superstar wife. Tell everyone what this event means to you.
Oh, it's fantastic. I love the fact that women can be the focal point of a disc golf event. And that was our vision in 2011. And it's, you know, if you would have told me back then that Terry Miller, the disc golf guy, would be covering the Rocky Mountain Women's Disc Golf Championship and that we'd have the sponsorship that we do and the participation and that several of the top ranked women in the world would be here, I would have said, wow, I don't think that's going to happen, but it has. And I think this is the future of the sport. You know, the more women that are playing it's going to help our game. Without a doubt, I'm 100% convicted of that, and Ray and I both believe in supporting that. So, and it was awfully special to have my wife and daughter both play, and first time we've had live scoring at RMW DGC too.
Very
so
cool.
I sat in the tent and I'm going refresh, and I kept hitting it. And when I found out that Paige had locked up third place in this field, I was like, oh my gosh! And it was I couldn't fit under the tent because I think my grin was
yeah.
so big.
But, well, you should be proud, and it's a very exciting moment and a very amazing weekend. As they said, more than 120 women, huge waiting list. And the sponsorship, Dynamic Disc was our presenting sponsor. Vibram helped get me out here to help provide some of the coverage, like you said, live scoring. And that's also a testament to the caddy situation and so many other people with their hands on deck. Our cameraman, Chad, here. I mean, everybody's hands on deck at an event like this.
Yep.
How do you rope so many people into doing work with you or for you?
Well, I mean, providing a course like this for them to play, providing the experience, and just taking good care of the volunteers, you know, make them feel welcome and special. So,
yeah, people believe in this, and we just want to create a conduit for them to be a part of it. And I would say we're pretty proud today that this thing went off like
Definitely.
It did. I mean, I never dreamed I'd have to, you know, manage a gallery. It's the first time I've done that in my life, so that was kind of cool.
Well, it was very special. Cool. Like I said, I was talking to Sarah Holcomb and a few of the other players earlier saying, I have bucket list courses and I have kind of bucket list events. And this event, you know, because I've heard so much about it, it was just a no-brainer for me to be out here as a promoter and a big advocate for women's disc golf. And so for me to be here to see what you guys are accomplishing was, I can check that off my bucket list as well. So great job.
Well, we hope you don't check it completely off.
No,
be here
no.
in 2 years.
All right.
That's
well,
right.
That certainly could be a range I'd love to. Maybe we could turn down the heat next time.
Yeah, exactly.
No rain, no snow, and no heat. How's that? Right in the middle?
Be awesome.
Or do we have to go to San Diego for all that?
I think that's where that is. Yeah.
All right. Again, for Doug and Ray and myself, Terry Miller, the Disc Golf Guy, it's been an amazing week out here. We hope that you enjoy all the coverage that's come to you. Again, that's brought to you large in part by our supporters over at Vibram, who are sponsors of the event, and this event being presented by Dynamic Disc and all the work that they've done. Again, I'm Terry Miller, the Disc Golf Guy. Let's go turn down the heat.
And finishing 16 and under, first place, Michaela Klein. Okay. And in first place for 13 and under, Macy Klein. And winning the rec division for the RMWDC 2015 is Miss Cooper. I don't know her
position. You know, just because it's just a women's event, we can still have sandbaggers. You need to move up.
And your RMWDC 2015 intermediate winner, with a score of 153, Suzanne Wicklund.
Move up.
Speech.
So,
and a local favorite winning Advanced Masters at the RMW DGC 2015, Karen Sattler. And in first place, the Advanced Women's RMW DGC 2015 champion, Jess Matthews. Okay, our 2015 RMW DGC Pro Masters champion taking home $1,605, Tavish Cardiff.
First thing for my team P girls over here and the ones that aren't here. Shout out to Kansas City Wide Open, which I missed this year to be here, and I think right now they're going to forgive me.
Yeah!
Maybe. And my super caddy, David. Thank you.
From Pensacola, Florida, winning $425, Madison Walker.
Yeah, man.
This is my first time playing disc golf in Denver.
Yeah,
it's awesome. And I like that it's at a women's tournament because they're my favorite. Thank you, Innova Disc and Dynamite Disc.
In fifth place, winning $580, which I understand might be a help for an upcoming event in her life, Ragna Bigda.
So I'd like to start by thanking my caddy, Scott. Could definitely not have done this without him. I had a pretty rough second round and definitely kept my head out of it. After that, I'd just like to thank Prodigy and Under 54. Thank you.
In fourth place, our 2013 RMW DGC champion, who also was a big part of the reason why Disc Golf for Women in Innova was such a big supporter of this event, winning $730, Valerie Jenkins.
And it's all thanks to everybody that helped here, all you caddies, all the baskets, everybody that purchased the basket. Thank you guys so much. It's a pleasure being here. Thank you.
Okay, this one might be a little tough. Winning the third place glass mini trophy and winning $945, Paige Bjerkus.
My dad being in the house all the time, he's always working on this tournament. Like, you know, when he decided to do it every other year, they already had a lot planned for that year, and that really continued into this year, and they've both been working so hard. I see my dad meeting with Ray almost every day, and they just put so much work into this tournament. I want to specifically say thank you to my dad. Happy Father's Day. I love you so much. I am so grateful to have a dad like you and my mom. And like, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here right now and playing disc golf, so thank you. This was insane. Thank you for everyone who's cheering me on. I kind of surprised myself this weekend, and I'm still very excited about it. And the most important, I'd like to thank my wonderful caddy, Joel. He is amazing. On the course, off the course, he's just an inspiration, and he definitely helped me throughout this whole tournament, through my ups and downs. So, thank you.
Okay, so if you didn't know and weren't on this side of the course, we went to a sudden death playoff to determine who would be the champion. And I need the other champion. And the two competitors decided to split the first and second place cash, which means they are each going home with a check for $1,705. Taking home the second place title, and $1,705 is Paige Pierce.
Thank these guys. You guys have a way of making a B tier seem like a major championship, and that's something you can't really find anywhere else. Congrats to all the women that came out, 130 women and like, what, 50 on the waitlist or more? That's incredible. Especially the fact that every single woman had a caddy. That is awesome. We have women's tournaments in Texas. I just went to one in Cali and both of them were amazing, but this one definitely tops them because of that. There's guys that are literally paying to come out in this 100 degree weather and walk 48 holes in one day. So thank you guys, and especially my caddy, Eric. Thank you for signing up again after my tournament 2 years ago. I'm sure I didn't have the best attitude back then, but I'm working on it. Thank you to Jeff. You're amazing. Hospitality was great. Thanks to Doug for hooking that up. Congrats to Sarah. You killed it out there. It's hard to make up any ground when every hole is two-able and you're two-ing them all. So congrats to you. Thanks to my sponsors, Prodigy Disc, Twisted Flyer, Cali Connection, Keen Footwear, and Whale Sex.
Our 2015 RMW DGC Open Champion. This is the fourth champion we've had, starting with Paige Bjerkus, followed by Katrina Allen, followed by Valerie Jenkins. We've got a good line of champions, our fourth champion for 2015, taking home $1,705, as well as the first place Pyroheiser Glass Mini, Sarah Hokum.
It's awesome to see all these faces out here. 130 women is amazing. Doug and Ray, you guys are rocking it and taking the women's sport to the next level. Without you guys, we wouldn't be experiencing these types of things and setting the bar so much higher. So thank you guys, for real. I also gotta thank Sean for carrying my heavy bag all weekend. Thank you so much. John for putting us up, wherever you are, there you are. Thank you so much. We really appreciate all that help. And congrats to all the other women. Paige, great battle. Man, you're always so good. I always feel lucky every time I win. I gotta thank my sponsors, Legacy Disc, Cali Connection, Paragon, and Plastic Addicts. I gotta say happy Father's Day to my dad, and thanks to my family for coming out.
Well, that concludes RMW GGC 2015.
Cameraman.
Good thing you got a caddy.
Yep.